Hi guys, it is Amanda, Little Beach Panda here. And guess what I'm about to do? Okay. I won tickets. Okay, first of all, let me start over. When I was young, I used to be in love with these twin rock and rollers named the Nelsons, Matthew and Gunnar Nelson, okay? And seeing what's behind me, making sure ain't nothing, you know, incriminating. Okay, that's good. And so, you know, and I'm 40, I was in elementary school. Fast forward today, they're 55, okay? Well, they're having a Christmas special here in Springfield, Missouri at the Gilroy's, however you pronounce it, theater, downtown. And, oh my God. And I won tickets to go. I entered on Facebook, tagged my mommy, wrote him a message, you know, telling them how, because that's what you have to do, tag somebody and write a message, telling them how, you know, they were my elementary school crush. I had their t-shirt, I had their VHS tapes, and how it would be so nostalgic to see them in 2022 for their Christmas special and a great way to end the year. And well, I won 2 tickets to see them tonight, okay? I don't have anybody else to go with me, so right now I'm Ubering there and I'm going by myself. So that's that on that. But guys, I have absolutely nothing to wear. Like nothing, okay? I've been wearing the same shit since I've been here because it's been cold, which is a sweatshirt and pants. So, and it's cold outside. It's like less than 20 degrees, okay? So I've got leggings on underneath these jeans, okay? High socks, my socks go up to here, okay? Jeans and then these Jordans, okay? I'd rather wear these than those, my Westbrooks. So, and then I have a little hoodie jacket that I'm about to put on over this, and then I'm gonna put my black coat on. So that's gonna be my OOTN, outfit of the night. All right, folks? I already did my hair, got my makeup. Oh my God. See, the jacket is gonna make it where we won't see any of this, because no, that's gross. But yeah, guys, so I don't know if I'll be able to record in there, but we will record up till we cannot record. Okay, a little date night by myself. Okay, let's do it.
Guys. Well, I don't know where I'm going. First, I gotta see where I'm going. Row F, seat 12, orchestra. Okay, guys, I'm getting in here for free. Here we go. Well, they serve alcohol, folks. Cocktails, shots, wines, drafts, and soft drinks. Interesting. She's seating me, folks. Oh my goodness, this is interesting. Excuse me. Wow.
Of ours, and they stopped in front of our house to sing to us. You know, one of my favorites. Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la.
Okay, Ricky, hit the switch.
Shows again a few months ago, and it's refreshing to be here, not only because it's a Christmas show, but because it doesn't look like a doctor's convention. Thank you for that. By the way, before I go any further, that's not Black Bart, that's Gunnar Nelson on the Telecaster. Woo!
Oh, yeah.
The twin with his own theme music. Good twin, evil twin. It is funner with Gunnar. But your MC, my big brother by 45 minutes, Mr. Matthew Nelson, everybody. Remember show, if you've seen that around, I don't know, if not, we're going to have to come back and do that one. We also stole them from quite a while now. Last time we played was We were in Minnesota. Yeah, we got out of there just in time. We really, honestly, if we had two more hours where we were playing in St. Cloud, we wouldn't have made it out to this concert, or we would have driven an awfully long time very slowly to get here.
Man, I was just glad to get to the airport.
Absolutely.
You guys had no sympathy.
No.
At all. You shuttled half the year. It's okay. I get it. But we're really glad to be here, folks, as Matthew was touching on. Really, a couple years ago, when that whole thing went down, we were told by all of our advisors, we had no idea if live music was ever going to come back. For real. Obviously, we didn't know what we were dealing with back then. Actually, technically, still don't. Mm-hmm. But we're so grateful to be here. We really are. We knew when that whole thing happened that we were non-essential. We just didn't know we were dangerous.
Right.
So let's bring a little danger to you. I hope you guys are ready after what everybody's been through for a couple of years to have Christmas spirit. I think the world needs a little bit of the Nelsons right now, too. So we're going to bring that to you. Hope you're going to have a good time. Yeah. That's what you're here for. Top 10 of all-time selling pop music artists in history. Give it up for Papa. And the governor and I showed up, and we sold about 7 million records to people who had no idea who Ozzy and Harriet or Ricky Nelson were. And yeah, some of you in here might have watched me look like Hot Swedish Chicks back in 1990. Woo! They always line up in front of the governor. Just happens every time. They know he's dangerous. They like the bad
guy. Oh, yeah.
I don't think so. Okay, so it's a Christmas show, man. I know. Well, as a matter of fact, I wanted to say this too. This is kind of a party for us. Please forgive him, it's an ugly thing to see.
It really is. Dancing with the Stars would be my nightmare. Here we go.
I got this one here. Okay, you start.
Christmas show on this tour, and we had a run where we did five in a row all over the state of Texas, and Texas is a big state. I had no idea driving that how big that really was, and because our agents are sadists, they had us booked on all the corners of the state, and so if we weren't on stage, we were driving, not sleeping a lot. And folks, I don't know if any of you have ever been so tired that you forgot which twin you were. It happened to me. This particular night, it was our fifth show in Texas, and we were playing at a mega church. And there were about 4,000 incredibly uptight church ladies at this show. Now, at this point in the intermission, I am supposed to say, like I said 100 times doing this, we're going to do an intermission, we're going to do 15 minutes for the guys, 20 minutes for the girls, we know how it is. And it's supposed to give you an opportunity to visit with your neighbors, and I'm supposed to say, and let you stretch your legs and spread your wings. Now my brain was making total sense, but my mouth went on strike halfway through that last sentence. And Matt's concerned because that day I told 4,000 incredibly uptight church ladies to go to the lobby and spread their legs. So on that note, go spread your legs. We'll see you in 20 minutes.
So we're in the intermission.
Yeah, you guys keep dancing, everybody else. Mm-hmm. All right, but you feel better? Little, not really. I feel like $100. Because I don't quite know what a million feels like.
Right.
But it's good to be back. This is my favorite part of the show, because this is kind of like we're going to come back with my section of the show.
You know, the thing is, it's always interesting being a twin, because, you know, whether he starts something and I finish it, or I start something and he finishes it, this is one of those things where it really worked out, because I thought it was going to do something really tender and sweet and talk about, you know, Christmas toys and what children wanted from Santa and all that stuff and how interesting it changed over the years. And Governor went full dark on it. It was really fun.
I had some fun, because I mentioned a little earlier that we were kids of the 70s, so we're going to go forward a little bit to our childhood Christmases with our dad, at a time when our childhood heroes of the day were Bruce Lee and Evel Knievel. All right? We were not wusses back then. All right, kids were tough back then. You notice these days, there's no kid in the neighborhood that's got a cast on anything anymore. When we were kids, someone always had a cast on something, right? There was always a story to go along with it. Before video games, kids were the video game. No extra lives included, right? And if you were dumb enough to try to fly off the backyard shed, you just didn't get to grow up and join the gene pool. That's just the way it worked. So childhood was kind of a matter of survival of the fittest. And in the 70s, we had the greatest Christmas toys ever. The more death-defying, the better. And we kind of grew up on television, especially Saturday morning cartoons and stuff. And right around November, they started running these things, and everything was some assembly required. You remember that was the thing? And that was right around the time Matthew and I got the greatest Christmas gifts that we'll ever get. Our Schwinn Stingray bicycles.
Number 5. Creepy crawlers in the thing.
But he said, this is great because it's like a flying bus. It never gets above where you need oxygen up there. It flies slow and low, and it takes off at 70 miles an hour. You know, so he thought it was like a flying duck. He can't get hurt in this thing. It's ironic. But what was great about it was fully restored and just beautiful, this plane. It attracted a lot of attention at airports by pilots and stuff. And so our dad, we got all excited to go with him. And he went out of town for a gig, and he was going to come back and collect us on the plane at Van Nuys Airport. And the night before, he called us. Our bags are packed and the whole thing. We're just excited, you know, because the band was our second family. And he said, boys, I've really been thinking about it, and I'm pretty firm about this. I want you to fly and meet me in Dallas, commercial. And I'm going to meet you there after doing a couple of stops on my plane. And we were really upset about it, because we just thought, oh, this is a great bonding experience. We get on the plane and hang out and be the guys and all that stuff. And he said, no, I mean, I'm serious. I mean, this is not going to happen. I'm going to meet you in Dallas. And I'm firm about it. And our dad never got that way. He was really laid back, I know. But it was like he knew something. And that phone call changed. It saved our lives, because he never came back. And the thing about it is, we always play these shows, and this is such a wonderful time for us, because we get to reconnect with our whole family, multiple generations, and let you all into the front door. And the truth is, all these years later, Gunnar and I would give anything for 5 more minutes with our pop. He's such a sweet guy. We miss him every day. And the one regret we have is that he was never there with us when we sold all of our records, or sold out the Universal Amphitheater, which was the last place we saw him playing. So he was there in spirit. But if we could do anything over again, it would be to figure out a way to back him up and play in his band or something like that. So we have a little surprise for you. All right, time to write a poem. Go ahead and go dark if you can. If all of our friends that we went to high school with, they went to college. Uh-huh. We went on tour. We won. It was so much fun.
It was really cool.
Well, we're going to keep with the Christmas spirit. We can't do a total left.
Oh, yeah.
The demons I thought were dead and gone. Straight out of the blue, someone like you comes along.
But you're here now, and it's amazing to me with what everybody has been through. Do you remember at the beginning of this? They said, we're all in this together. And then they spent every effort to divide everybody right up the middle. And there's a reason for that, because together, we're all unstoppable. And the one thing I do know is that isn't it amazing when the powers that be take everything that we are trained to go after our entire lives, to get on that treadmill for, the bigger house, the faster car, the stuff gets taken away. We're kind of forced to take another look at what's really important in life, right? Which truly is your family, your friends, your loved ones, and your faith. That's it. That's all we need.
Everything that happens at Christmas time.
Right? Christmas. Christmas is just a wonderful kind of time that we can be reminded every year on a normal year that 364 other days of the year, we should be that person we are on Christmas Day. We have the opportunity to do it. The world needs it right now.
Absolutely.
So if anybody's trying to convince you that your neighbor is dangerous and that God is not revealed, they're lying and they're selling something. That's all I'm saying. And that said, please indulge me. I know all fun aside in my Christmas top five and all of that, we had fun with this, but I am proud to say that this is not a holiday show. This is a Christmas show. We hope you guys have a wonderful 2023, that the worst is behind us, and that we all reconvene at some time next year, down the road, some other place. And Gunnar and I always talk about this too, that just remember, no matter what happens in the near or distant future, just try to remember that whether or not you agree with somebody's point of view, the person you're facing has struggles you know nothing about. So just respect them, and more importantly, there was one guy that said the most important thing is loving everybody, right? Love each other. So don't forget that, and I think that the song we're gonna end this with says that. It's all about, as a matter of fact, this whole show is, when we put this together, we realized at the end of it that we weren't the geniuses we thought we were, God was, because it started with our grandparents' episode, Busy Christmas, which was all about love, prosperity, and peace to all of you, and we'll see you this time next year, hopefully. All right? Yeah.
Okay, guys, hi. I'm back in my room in my bed. I Ubered back here. I got some Wingstop, and yeah, I'm just gonna smoke a blunt and pass out. It's like 12:30, so it's officially December 17th. I'm officially going home tomorrow. I'm going home Sunday. Can't wait to see my boyfriend and my animals. But yeah, the Nelson's Christmas special was cool. Oh, hold on. I gotta show y'all my autograph I got. I wasn't gonna get up, but I gotta show y'all. I went ahead and paid $20. And got this. That's what they used to look like back whenever, you know, I mean, I was in love with them. So I splurged $20 and got that. And yeah. So yeah, I hope if you watched this, you enjoyed it. And go YouTube the Nelsons. Can't live without your love and affection. And watch that. And also Google After the Rain and watch that. Yeah, they were fine as wine. And they're still good looking. But you know. I miss them long blondes. But okay, guys. Thank you for being a subscriber, watching this, and I love you. Okay. Mwah.